Hello, Kevin here. I'm the producer at VideoTekk, and I produce live streams and other kinds of video-related functions for various things. I'm just going to walk you through here a little bit and show you this particular live stream as a bit of an example of a wedding shoot. And this was quite an involved wedding shoot, actually. It used my biggest camera setup at the moment, consisting of 9 different cameras, and all cameras used were actually wireless and fully remote controlled. So that meant that I could stay out of sight, away from where the actual wedding was, and operate all the sound and video that you see in this live stream. And that means no cameramen were used either. I was actually moving the cameras myself, as I said, remote controlled. And so that meant I could position cameras all around the area where we were shooting, and there's no cameraman in the way, nothing for people to look past, and the cameras themselves are very small, and you can hardly even notice that they're there. So perfect for this kind of situation and a lot of things. So just to let you know, I can do video shoots like this for almost any kind of purpose. You know, this particular one is a wedding, but it could be for a conference, for a school play, for a hockey game, soccer game, live performance of some sort. I mean, you name it. Pretty much anything where you've got some sort of action or some kind of event going on where you'd like people to watch it, you can live stream it now. Live streaming has really just kind of caught on in the public awareness, especially with the whole COVID thing going on, and people really started realizing that, yeah, we still want to be able to communicate to people. We want people all over the world to be able to see what it is that we're doing. And so now there's basically no restrictions at all. I mean, you can put on any sort of event. And, you know, it doesn't have to be a really expensive prospect to do it either. I mean, this kind of thing is affordable to the average person for literally any purpose now. And yet you can go worldwide and let people interact with your video and you, even in real time, leaving comments or taking part in the live stream. So live streaming is something everybody can use now, whether you're a business trying to promote something, you know, a charity that's trying to get information out there, or in this case, just some kind of personal project like putting on your wedding. So that's the subject for today, and here we are with Abby and Neil. Thank you very much for having me out. Abby herself is actually a wedding planner too, so check her out and what she does at Urbana Collective. What you're seeing here now too, we started out basically with the introductory graphic. Normally that's what we would do for a live stream. We start streaming 20 minutes early or so. That's typical. Maybe a little less. And so we'll put up a graphic or just a straight camera shot, you know, just to let people know what's coming. And in this case, the bride, Abby, wanted people to see everyone in the audience that was walking in. And this particular version that you're watching is the edited high quality HD version of the live stream. The actual live stream itself didn't look considerably different in terms of quality. Turned out really well, but there was a lot more at the beginning and ends that I've trimmed out here, just so you could see the major components of what the live stream consisted of. And so we've got our introduction, the intro graphic, just a few scenes, shots. As you're watching here, you'll notice, of course, that I've got multiple different camera angles on screen at the same time. And, you know, we weren't necessarily sure where people were going to come from when entering and sitting down and all that. So, I mean, there's no firm plan with something like this. Things just happen, and you got to be able to capture it. Various camera angles, we did that for a good part of the pre-wedding phase while everybody was just walking in there, and I'm just showing you a few of them here. It was actually nice to be able to capture the walk-in of bridesmaids, best men, bride and groom, and all that. All of them coming in from their official walk-in area, but then to be able to see them from various camera angles as they did so. So you didn't just have one really quick shot that went by really fast. You could, you know, whatever caught your eye or whatever seemed most interesting, you know, you could see them coming from a distance and then maybe a side view of them. And so that's kind of what the start was like. A nice way to just kind of see the environment and get a feel for what's going on. And then finally we, you know, once the wedding actually started, we went back to a straight single shot on screen at one time. And yeah, but that's the nice part. You know, again, 9 camera angles, you know, you never get that anywhere else. You know, if you go to other weddings or most events, they're using one or maybe 2 cameras. They're both manned, typically. And you're going to pay those guys a heck of a lot more money just to have people running those cameras than you are to have me out at VideoTekk here. And I can give you 9 different viewpoints. And not only those 9, but I mean, again, since I can control the cameras, you can get a particular shot with one camera and then you see a better shot, or you won't need to adjust it a little bit or something. You can move it over. You know, it's not fixed into the one area. And obviously 9 different angles is going to give you a lot more coverage, a lot more interesting coverage than just 1 or 2 people can. So it's a heck of an advantage over typical videographers. Anyways, that's about it. Also want to say, of course, there is a lot of care taken with the audio, because nobody's going to watch your video if there's not good audio to go with it. In this particular case, there were numerous microphones put out. So we had the main microphone for the officiant. And originally the plan was he was just going to hold the mic for both the bride and groom, but they wanted to keep their hands free, and they had a special little lighting candle ceremony and all that. So they requested having lav mics put on them. And it was actually a good idea. Normally I do that as just a backup. You know, because you can never have, you know, be reliant on one particular thing and hope it's always going to work. You know, there can be unforeseen problems or things that happen when you're dealing with equipment, of course. So here at VideoTekk, naturally, I have backups for every single important piece that you've got to have. So we don't just have that main microphone. We have the 2 spare backup lavs right on the bride and groom themselves. There was also 2 other handheld microphones waiting on standby in case the officiant's mic went down or had interference for some reason. And then towards the back where the PA system was, where everybody was listening to everything, there was actually a shotgun mic, so it was picking up sound from the speakers themselves, and then just the natural environment sounds and people, you know, laughing or whatever all else. I mixed that into this to give it a good sense of atmosphere. And then there was still a further microphone and recorder just running and recording everything, basically. You know, what if your audio for some reason got corrupted on your hard drive or who knows what? You know, I got a backup recording of the audio that you can sync to the video. So basically every point of failure was planned for, predicted, in case it happened, and you have backups for it. And, you know, even the cameras themselves, I mean, say if a camera went down, I mean, you've got at least 8 other cameras then that you can work with, which is plenty. So anyway, that's typical of how I do things, and, you know, why you want to go with somebody that does things professionally, you know, because sure, anybody can just hold up their phone and take a couple minutes of video, but I mean, how is it going to look? How is it going to sound? And, you know, obviously they can't give you all these different shots, and they can't give you really good, clear, direct audio, you know, without proper microphones and mixing. And that's the other thing I can mention. We actually did 2 separate mixes, one that was live for the crowd to listen to while they're there, and then at the same time, a separate mix just for the live stream. You know, and so both those things had different elements going to it and different levels for things. And again, you know, that's something that's normally just not possible. You know, if you're just going to hold up a phone or a camera or whatever it is that you're using to record. You know, this was a very well planned for production. And anyways, I think that sums things up. I thought you might be interested to hear a bit more from me as to what goes into a live stream, as opposed to just strictly watching through somebody else's wedding here. But while I've been talking, you've been able to see what those results are. So hope you enjoy this. And remember, we could do this for your wedding or any kind of public or private event. And you can live stream it to your choice of social media, private web page, or we could do pay-per-view, you know, in the case of concerts or sports or anything you want to charge some kind of viewer ticket prices to. That can all be done. So come see me, Kevin, at VideoTekk.
It says, you know you're in love when you really can't fall asleep because reality is finally better than your dreams. With this understanding, Neil and Abby wish to be joined together in marriage. All right. Therefore, if any person can show just and sufficient reason why these two persons may not be joined in matrimony, let them declare reasons, or else from this time forward, keep their peace. I now call upon you both in the presence of these witnesses to repeat after me. Abby? Okay. I do. Solemnly declare.
Solemnly declare.
That I do not know of any lawful impediment.
That I do not know of any lawful impediment. Why I, Abby Toledo.
May not be joined in matrimony to Neil Clissold.
May not be joined in matrimony to Neil Clissold.
Neil? Neil.
This should be good now.
I do.
Solemnly swear.
That I do not know of any lawful impediment. Why I, Neil Clissold. May not be joined in matrimony to Abby Toledo.
In matrimony to Abby Toledo.
Did we yes. have drinks? Like, what is this?
Well done.
Only one third through this.
Now, would Neil and Abby please face each other and join hands? As no impediment was declared or admitted, Neil and Abby have each prepared their own vows that they will read now. Neil, you may begin.
Okay. Had to write this down. It was a little bit last minute, but okay. About I love you as you love me. Through all our peaks and valleys, promise to answer your calls like 80% of the time, maybe 90%.
Bad. That's not a good vow.
I'll work every day to be a better husband to you. We'll appreciate your patience. When your patient wears thin, and it will, I'll work harder. Always be there for you, and we'll have more peaks and valleys.
Thank you. Abby?
Oh, my turn. I have a belt, so. Yes. So, 4 years ago, it's going to be a story, guys. I turned to a friend for comfort, and during one of the hardest times in my life. And we all know that Neil is not great with comforting people, and he didn't do it very well. But he did remind me, he reminded me to be confident. Obviously, I'm not doing well right now. To weather hard times, and that I'm a strong and independent woman, who I am today because of you. So we all know that I could talk for like days about all my vows and stuff like that. So I've narrowed it down to three really important vows. So vow number one, I promise to love you no matter what you look like, no matter what you sound like at night, and no matter what you smell like.
None of these are gonna be good.
Vow number two, this one's a really hard one for me, but I promise to never murder you. But I do reserve the right to come up with interesting ways that I can murder you and dispose of your body correctly. And lastly, the most important vow, number three, we have the best relationship and it's really easy. We're compatible. That's why we're getting married, apparently. But I'm not naive. I know that it's going to be hard at some point. Why did we do this outside? We're going to want to call it quits. And I promise you that I will never let you forget that I love you, and that I will always remind you that I have today, and just like you reminded me in the beginning.
I think it's your turn.
May I please have the rings?
Your mask is... Oh. What's wrong with your mask?
They've been sanitized.
Having declared... Neil and Abby will now exchange rings as a symbol of love and commitment to each other. Having declared these marriage vows, Neil... Place the ring on the third finger of Abby's left hand.
Should we hold hands?
Please repeat after me. As a sign of my love. That's you.
Oh, sorry.
As a
sign of our love.
That I have chosen you.
That I have chosen you.
Above all else.
Above all else.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I be wed. Thee wed. Thee wed.
Abby, having declared these marriage vows, Abby, place the ring on the third finger of Neil's left hand, repeating after me.
Have we gotten fat?
This is not new.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
That I have chosen you.
That I have chosen you.
Above all else.
Above all else.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed. We're married. Oh, no.
Not yet.
Okay.
Still need paperwork.
Filipino weddings reflect the strong traditions of family and symbolism. Neil and Abby have chosen to honor Abby's Filipino heritage by including a traditional candle, veil, cord, and coin symbolic ceremony. We should face each other. Possibly kneel.
Oh, possibly.
Please.
Oh, we have legs.
We have stools.
Do you want to grab a cushion? Okay.
I ask Neil and Nancy to join us and to lay a veil over you. Through the passing of the years, let the veil remind you that you belong to each other and no one else. You well belong to one house and will shelter each other and those around you together. I invite Ryan and Audrey to place a cord over you. This cord symbolizes an infinite bond of love you share that keeps your relationship strong in the face of adversity, as well as that you are both no longer two, but one in marriage. The cord looped and crossed in the center, a symbol of infinity, is wrapped around you to symbolize the infinite nature of your marriage. Now let's do an exchange of the eras, or coins. I invite Deanna to present the coins. The coins are a reminder of good stewardship, that they will mutually support each other and the world around them. Yes, please. Neil, please repeat after me. Abby, I give you these coins as a pledge of my dedication to you. And my willingness to care for you and our home. Abby, please repeat after me. Neil. I accept them. And in the same way. Pledge my dedication to you. And to care of our home and for you. Go ahead and put it back.
God.
Okay. I invite Paul and Elle to light the individual candles. The individual candles represent all that you are and all that you have been until this moment. It is a candle of unity because both candles must come together to create the new light. This is also a candle of commitment because it takes two people working together to keep it ablaze. Neil and Abby, please light the center candle to symbolize the union of your lives. Close. It's going. I would like to call on the wedding party to remove the cord and veil. And Glenn to take the coins. Now, I invite the bride and groom to sign the marriage certificate, as well as their two witnesses.
I'm graceful. Okay. I'm stuck. I'm pretty sure. Okay. I feel like we signed the spouse side.
Wait, do I need to sign there?
Yes.
Oh,
you signed
the witness
one. We can't get married now. It's fine.
You're playing us off, I think.
Okay, so do you want to sign the...
Okay. Well, at this point, I'm supposed to give marriage advice. So again, I'll dive deep into our culture, and I'd like to paraphrase Scott Adams, the immortal creator of Dilbert. Neil, love her like a fat kid loves cake.
I like cake.
I know you do. Neil and Abby, you have consented in marriage, and I have declared your solemn intention before these witnesses and in my presence. You have exchanged these rings as the pledge of your love to each other. You have joined your hands to accept one another. Now, upon the authority invested in me by the province of Alberta, I pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Okay. Sorry. Our song didn't play, but it's okay. We'll just... Okay, this was fine. Yay!
You might want to take that in case it rains. Yeah, thanks.